Praise the Lord. Praise God. I'm so glad to be here. And it's always good after Thanksgiving, we are remembering to give thanks, hopefully not of all the other festivities and festivals that are going on, but we are to always give thanks. And that's the center of my message today, is to be thankful. Be thankful to God. With all the festivities and all the things going on, Black Friday and food and family and maybe just time to get out and see all the things that are going on, we can get caught up. We can get caught up in society's ways of the holidays. People, you go to Starbucks or you go to any place that says Happy Holidays, and we can get caught up in the holiday season. But how many of us are thankful? And I want to do a message on thankfulness, because last week we had a guest speaker, and I think it's important for us, even as Christians, to remember that we are to be thankful people, and ultimately giving thanks to God. How many remember to give thanks to God? How many remember to do that every day?
Amen.
Every day, at least 5 times. That sounds like a lot. That sounds like a lot, but that is still not enough. Mm-hmm. We need to always be giving thanks to the Lord. Let's open up to Matthew chapter 13, verse 19. Do you remember this? Jesus was feeding the 5,000, and this is right after John the Baptist was killed. John the Baptist, how many are familiar with John the Baptist? John the Baptist was the one who identified Jesus Christ. He said, what did he say? This is the Messiah, the Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world. John the Baptist was the first to identify Jesus as the Son of Man, the Savior of the world. And so all his disciples followed him, and they needed his leadership. And so 5,000 people were following Jesus. Amen? Amen?
Amen.
Amen. So let's read chapter verse 14, verse 13. When Jesus heard what had happened, he withdrew by a boat privately to a solitary place. Hearing of this, the crowds followed him on foot from the towns. You know, when Jesus comes into the world, people want to come hear him. People want to come hear him. And yesterday we had a funeral service for Hito. He was one of our renters. But, you know, we used that opportunity to present the gospel. I want to let you know Pastor Sprigg spoke a powerful message yesterday about salvation. She said, if you don't believe in Jesus, you're not going to go to heaven. Hiroto needs to believe in Jesus. And she gave this whole message and showed illustration. And it is so important for us to share the gospel. People are waiting to hear. Even his daughter said, I used to go to church. And when you play that music, I want to go back to church. She even cried. Because the Holy Spirit was touching her. The Holy Spirit was moving in her. She wants to be in worship with you. She wants to be here. In the same way, these people are wanting to be with Jesus. 5,000 people walk on foot to see Jesus. How many of you are willing to walk on foot to see Jesus? Amen. The fact that you're here, you drove here, I think is showing a lot of your ability to walk forward with Jesus. When Jesus landed and saw the large crowd, he had compassion on them and he healed the sick. Jesus is the Son of God. He can do that. As the evening approached, the disciples came and said, this is a remote place, and it's getting late. Send the crowds away so they can go to the village and buy themselves food. This is very rational. The disciples are very rational people. He said, God, this is too many people. You need to get rid of them. You need to get them out of here. How many people are rational people? They put their thoughts before anything can happen. Now think of that. They said, the disciples are reasonable. They said, how are we going to feed all these people? There's too many people here. But Jesus, I want you to know this, Jesus is a miracle maker. Jesus is the Son of God. God can do things, impossible things. How many believe that?
Yes.
God can do impossible things. Amen?
Amen?
God can do impossible things. Jesus replied to them, they don't need to go away. But you give them something to eat. We have 5 loaves of bread and 2 fish. Is that enough to feed 5,000 people?
No.
No.
No. We have 5 loaves of bread and 2 fish. Is that enough to feed 5,000 people? Yesterday we had a ministry, and we had a ministry to 7 people. Is our building big enough? It was small, but it was still good. We have faith. We have faith. We have here only 5 loaves of bread and 2 fish. Let me tell you something. Maybe in your life you have 5 loaves of bread and 2 fish, and you think things are impossible. But to God, to Jesus, he says, bring them to me. And he directed the people to sit down on the grass. Isn't Jesus nice? He says, hey, you're so hungry, go ahead and sit down. You don't need to stand up. To sit down. He takes the 5 loaves and 2 fish. That's it. 7 pieces of food. You know, you probably for Thanksgiving you had more than that. Probably this morning you had more than that. But Jesus took the 5 loaves and took, and looking up to heaven, he gave thanks and broke the loaves. Then he gave them to the disciples. Can you imagine that? He broke the loaves. He just kept going like this. I would have loved to see that. Jesus just breaking bread, passing out. Breaking bread, passing out. He's so calm. Jesus is saying, here, get here, disciples. Here, the Lord will provide. The Lord will provide. The Lord will provide. But I want to hint at, what did Jesus do before the miracle happened? What did Jesus do before the miracle happened? What did he do before the miracle happened?
He asked for the blessing of the bread.
He gave thanks. Yes, he asked for blessing. He gave thanks. He gave thanks. Before God does anything in your life, you should give thanks. When God does something in your life, you should give thanks. He did something that many of us in this world don't do. You know, when we pray before each meal, are we praying to eat? Dear Lord, I pray we can eat this food. Amen. Dear Lord, I pray we can do this. Japanese even have a saying, itadakimasu. It means I'm going to eat. But let me tell you the difference between Christians. We give thanks to God for even the food on our table. Amen.
Amen.
Yes.
We give thanks to God for everything we get. Everything we do, we give thanks to God. We fill our hearts with gratitude first before we eat. Maybe this is the start of, Lord, we give thanks for this food. Maybe Jesus is the one who started the prayer at the dinner table. Amen. Before God does anything, we should, before God can do a miracle in our lives, we need to learn how to give thanks. Jesus is saying, before I do this miracle, Jesus could have just done the miracle and not give any credit to God and say, here, I'll break the bread. I'll do this wonderful miracle. I'm God. I'm Yesama. But no, Jesus broke the bread. But before he broke the bread, he gave thanks to God. He gave thanks to God. He gave thanks to God for the meal. He gave thanks to God for what God is going to do. He didn't get caught up in the busyness. He could have, all 5,000 people, he could have gone up, he could have seen all the 5,000 people, said, oh my goodness, this is too many people. I don't know what to do. I don't know what to say. Maybe I should tell them to go home and listen to the disciples. But even under all that chaos, he said, sit down. He has control over the wind and the wave and people. And he said, sit down. We're going to give thanks. And he gave thanks to God, and the miracle happened. The miracle happened. I want to tell you, the power of giving thanks is more than just saying, God, thank you. But it's allowing God to be praised. And giving thanks is so important in doing that. Giving thanks is so important for us to do. I'm not just saying, do that because you feel good. That's what Thanksgiving's about. Do that because you feel great. You know, Thanksgiving is about giving thanks to God for providing for the Indians, for providing for the pilgrims. They wanted to give thanks to each other. Thanksgiving is so important for us as Christians. We're not just doing that to eat. We're doing that to give thanks to God. It's such an important thing. It's so important to give thanks to God. To set aside everything that you're doing. Before Jesus even broke the bread and started to distribute, what he do? He gave thanks to God. He gave thanks to God. Kami-sama-ni. Arigata. He gave thanks to God. He laid before him and he said, Lord, I give you thanks. You know, yesterday I have been working every day this week. I have been going out, Ventura, a person passed away. Person passed away on Thanksgiving. Can you imagine that? Person passing away on Thanksgiving. And then a person passed away right after that. And I had to go to Ventura, and I had to go drive all the way out to Ventura and be with this family and see the mortuary pick up the body. And it was a time of just being with people. I'm also a pastor who mourns with people, is there to comfort people, bring Jesus into the situation. And even yesterday, Saturday, I get another call and I got to go visit two other people in the morning. Nobody passed away, but I have to do these assessments. I have to visit people. And I said, Lord, I called them up the day before. I said, and they're Spanish speaking. They're Spanish speaking. And Spanish speaking people, I don't know if they understand what I'm saying. I don't know if they know who I am. I say, hello, I'm the hospice chaplain. I need to go see you. I need to visit with you. I need to see how you're doing. And they go, hola, como estas, you know, and they're speaking Spanish, and I'm confused. And I said, and I'm going, I need to see them, but do they understand me? And so I just, the daughter comes on the phone, I said, you know, tomorrow I'm going to come and see you, is that okay? And she said, yeah, okay, we're going to be there tomorrow morning. I said, okay, I'm going to trust that, because sometimes I go to these visits, and nobody's there, and I wasted my gas, and I wasted my time. And even the morning before that, I called this other family before because I have another family call. I said, hello, hey, I'm going to do a visit Saturday morning. Are you guys going to be there? He said, oh, yeah, we always have somebody there. Do they speak English? No, they speak Spanish. So I'm going, oh, no, Lord, please make these visits possible. I don't want to go there and waste my time. And Pastor Spring had to do a funeral yesterday, a memorial service. I wanted to be there and support them. And I said, God, just make all this work out. You know, God made everything work out. I'm going to just give you a little clue. God made everything work out. Again, I'm going to say that again. God made everything work out. Again, I'm going to say that again. God made everything to work out. I don't live by my reason. I don't live by the disciples' understanding. Hey, pull these people away. Get these people out of here. No, God will make a way. So yesterday morning, I'm driving to L.A. Best traffic in the world. Thank you, God. Nobody's on the road. God's favor. I got to get there at 10:30. Tucson, I got to get there at 10:30. Can you believe this? I'm going over there. I get to the place. I've been to a lot of healthcare centers. I go there. It's 10 o'clock. I'm going, God. Before I left, I said, God, be with me. Kami-sama, be with me. I said, God, you're going to prepare the way. That's all I did. And he prepared the way, made sure I made it there on time. I made it there. I went to the first place. I said, okay, they're not here yet. I'll go to the next place. Sure enough, I even prayed about that. I said, Lord, let it not be far away. Guess where it was? It was only 2 blocks away.
Oh.
I walked over to the next place. I went there. And I wasn't sure if I was going to meet anybody. Sure enough, I meet the family. God's first prayer request answered. I did my work. I did my duty. I prayed with them. I mourned with them. And I said, okay, God, number two, I got to make sure they're there. Remember, they're Spanish speaking. I don't know how this is going to work. But I gave faith. I go to the next place. Sure enough, right when I come back, they are there. Praise God. They are there. Praise the Lord. They are there. Praise God. Thank you, Lord. They are there. I go there. I'm like, where's the Duana Estrada? This is like a Spanish Duana. I shouldn't say her name, but that's her name. I'm going, okay. She doesn't know how to speak English. God provided her cousin to speak English. Translated the whole visit for me. I said, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. I could have wasted my time even just being there, but they were there. The family was there. It was 10. It was already 11 o'clock. And I said, I got time to get back. Service is at 2 o'clock today. God provided everything. I remember driving back on the street. I said, thank you, God. I was driving in my car. I said, thank you, God. You deserve all the praise. You deserve all the praise. I don't know if these people could understand my English. I even had to say, no habla inglés. I didn't know if they could understand me. So I had to give it to God. I had to give it to God. And God came through. Amen. Amen. And we also prayed for the funeral service. Yesterday, my mom did a radical impromptu funeral memorial service 2 days before. Hiroto died on Thanksgiving. This is really sad. He died, well, actually maybe a day before Thanksgiving. And my mom said, these people from Japan came. I'm going to do a memorial service. God even provided that. They were able to accomplish that. And we got to see his daughter, and we got to see his family, and we got to witness to them one time. He was a very staunch guy, and he didn't believe in Jesus. I hope you believe in Jesus. You don't know when you're going to die. I hate to break it to you. You don't know when you're going to die. If you know, let me know, because we'll do your funeral. But that's not the point. Point is, you don't know. And Pastor Spring knew that. She was saying, I wanted to minister to this guy, but I never got the chance. But she, yesterday, got the chance to minister to their family. Amen. Japanese. Most difficult people in the world to witness to. She did it. She is amazing. God used her. And let me tell you something. God is working through that. God is working through that. God is saying, are you going to do it? Are you going to give thanks? So I'm giving thanks for God for everything. I realized, I saw it from my angle, and I said, there's no way I could have done this without God. I couldn't have got those people. The appointment worked exactly on time. Remember, they don't speak English. And I needed to be back before 2. Everything I saw God unfolding. God preparing the way. I literally had to say thank you, God. I had to say thank you, God. I had to say thank you, God. There's nobody else who could pull that together. I can't say, Pastor Paul, can you make sure those people come? Hey, can you make sure? I can't call my hospice company and say, can you make sure they're there? I can't. It's part of my job. But what I can do is I can trust in the Lord. What I can do is believe that God will come through. And so I want to give him thanks. I want to give him thanks. I want to break my bread before him. That's all we do. That's all we're going to do. Once you give thanks to God, I guarantee you God will come through. Once you prepare the way for God to work, give him thanks when he's accomplished it. Too many people have not given thanks to God. Too many people live their life for themselves. And I do it too. I do it too. We all live for ourselves. Wow, thank you. Thank you for this food. Thank you for all that done. Feed me, feed me. But we have to give thanks to God. We have to give thanks to God. We have to give thanks to God. We have to say thank you, God. We have to give thanks to God. Thanks to God. We have to give thanks to God. You know, giving thanks to God. I gave thanks to God in the car. I knew that was the right response. I knew that was the only way I could do this. I said, thank you, God. I remember just in my car at the traffic light, I said, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. And I felt the Holy Spirit just come right in and say, great job. Good job. I said, amen. It's important to give thanks so we can stay humble to the Lord. We can stay reverent to God. Reverent to God and humble to the Lord. Say, God, thank you. Thank you, Lord. And it says in 1 Thessalonians 5:18, give thanks to God in all circumstances. Give thanks to God in all circumstances. You might have driven through traffic today. You might be hustling and bustling in life right now. But give thanks to God in all circumstances. Good or bad. Hard or difficult. It's when you don't give thanks, you start to doubt. It's when you don't give thanks, you start to get negative. Did you know that giving thanks to God is a form of worship? Yeah. Yeah. This morning I said, give thanks to God, for he is good. What else did we say? Count your what?
Count your blessings.
Count your many blessings. Count your many blessings. And you know, we need to do that. Every day, we should be counting our blessings. Every day, if you're breathing right now, if you're eating right now, if you're filled with the Holy Spirit right now, give thanks to God. If you have your husband right by your side, your wife right by your side, give thanks to God. If you have people here who love you, who care about you, give thanks to God. Find things to be thankful. You don't need to live in the world. You don't need to live in negativity. You don't need to live in self-centeredness. And self-centeredness, Japanese, is yokubari. I don't even like saying that. Yokubateru. I hate that. In order to get out of that, give thanks to God. Even if you're sick, even if you're feeling down, change your attitude and give thanks to God. Give thanks to God. Give thanks to God. I was even reading Psalms this morning from the prayer calendar, and the guy, the psalmist says, "Where, oh, where is God? He has left me, he has abandoned me." But then at the same time he goes, "I remember when you were good. I remember your good works in my life." He was giving thanks to God. I want you to live your life so you give thanks to God in all circumstances. 1 Thessalonians is one of my favorite verses. One of my favorite verses. Give thanks to God in all circumstances. If God has brought you here, if God has given you good health, if God has given you vision, if God has provided for you this week, count that. God, you got me to my place of work. God, you got those people together for me. I give thanks to you for that. Whatever God has done, give thanks. Give thanks in all circumstances. And when you give thanks, you're worshiping God. You're giving thanks to God. You're humbling yourself to God. And number two, you're getting rid of that negativity. It's easy to be negative, isn't it? Oh, I hate that person. Oh, I hate this. Oh, that's the worst traffic ever. Oh, why am I here? It's so easy to complain. It's hard to give thanks. We are born into sin. We are born to complain. We are born in negativity. We need to get out of negativity. We need to get out of that fleshly experience. We need to get away from Satan's temptation. And we need to start proclaiming thanksgiving. Thankfulness. Thankfulness. Thank you, God, for the health you've given me. Thank you, God, for the home that you have provided. Thank you, God, for the family and friends you have given to me. We have to be in a place of posture. There's so many things to be thankful for, and that's why God says give thanks in all circumstances, because he wants you to realize how good he is. Give thanks to God. Give thanks to God in all circumstances. Give thanks to God. That's why it's important. We want to give thanks to God to get rid of our negativity. And we want to give thanks to God so we can worship him. And we can see his work in our lives. I want you all to just say right now, thank you, God.
Thank you, God.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thanks be to God.
For the life.
For the life
that you've given me. Thank you, Lord, for this day.
For this day.
For this bread.
For this bread.
For our daily bread. Remember, it says, our Father who art in heaven, give us this day our daily bread. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. And we're giving thanks. It's all giving thanks for all the things that God can do. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. Give thanks to God. The Bible proclaims God's thanks for the purposes of for us to live in faith. When you give thanks to God, then you start to depend on God and you start to walk with God, and God begins to provide a way for you to live. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. I want you to just get that in your language. Get that as a language that you speak to God, that every good work that He does in your life, whether it's giving you the right medication, whether it's meeting the right person, or being in this place right now, give thanks to God. Jesus is showing us the example to give thanks. He didn't have to do that. He could have done His miracle. He could have split up the team, split up everything, probably make the water rise up and bit more fish. No, He's not a sign maker. But He gave thanks to God. I want you to live a life where you're giving thanks to God. I give thanks to God for all that you do. I'm going to pray right now. I'm going to pray right now. Receive this prayer right now. Lord God, I just pray right now, Holy Spirit, as You spoke of thanksgiving, I pray that each one of us will have a heart, a kokoro of thanksgiving, a heart of gratefulness. A heart that is saying, Lord, thank You for the life You've given me. Thank You for the food You've given me. Thank You for the day You've given me. Thank You for the clothes You've given me. Thank You for this church You've provided for me. Thank You, God, for all that You're doing in my life. And Lord, we pray for every person here to receive Your thankfulness. We pray right now, God, that there will be much, much more things we will be aware of to be thankful. And Lord, we give thanks for all that You've done today and what You will do tomorrow and what You will do in our lives. In the name of Jesus. Amen. How many receive that? How many receive that? Amen, amen. Good. Praise God.